So as I was preparing to film, like, it was so quiet, and now all of a sudden, as soon as I hit record, my neighbors are in their backyard with a squeaky wheelbarrow. Like, so if y'all hear any of that in the background, I apologize in advance. Right now I'm just priming. I'm using the Milk Gingerbread primer. All right, so y'all know I'm usually team eyeshadow before face, but with this underpainting technique, we're gonna move a little different today. So I'm just starting out with my concealer. This one is the Woke Concealer from Uoma Beauty. I'm just gonna apply it how I normally do. I'm gonna go in with a little bit more because I feel like this isn't giving me as much coverage as I want, especially since I don't have that foundation underneath it. I'm just gonna add a little bit more. Just for a little brightness, I'm going in with the Milk Concealer. Okay, so the concealer is all blended out now. So next I'm gonna go in with a cream contour. So I don't know if I'm gonna use my matchsticks from Fenty or my Uoma contour stick. I think I'm gonna start with the Fenty one because I know with the Uoma one, it can like get dramatic really fast. So I'm gonna start with the Fenty one, and if I feel like I need something more, then I'll use the Uoma. So I'm just gonna apply this where I contour. I don't like a whole lot. Snatch that jawline. I think that's good to start with. I'm gonna go ahead and blend that out with a sponge. I'm gonna make sure the sponge is just a little bit moist, because sometimes with these Fenty matchsticks, at least in my opinion, sometimes they can be a little dry. So I like to make sure I go in with a moist sponge so that they blend easier. Okay, so I am gonna take the Uoma stick just to deepen it up just a little bit, but only on my cheeks. And it's okay to go in a little heavy, just because you're gonna go over it with foundation anyway. So it'll all end up blending out. You don't want it to be like super light underneath your foundation, because then it'll just disappear. And then to bronze just a little bit, I'm gonna go in with Teddy. This is the Fenty Cream Bronzer, and I'm just gonna use just a little bit just to warm up my face. All right, so contour and bronzing is done. Before I put on my blush, I'm just gonna use a highlighter. I'm using like this one from Farsali. It's like a, ooh, I don't want to spill. It's like a gel. What is this called? Jelly Bean. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply that. And this is my first time using this one, but I'm pretty sure a little bit goes a long way. So I don't wanna overdo it. So I'm just gonna put that like on the high points of my cheek. And then I like to bring it up a little bit over the brow. That's pretty. Don't want to get that in my hair. So once again, high points of the cheek into the brow. Also gonna put some on my forehead, and then a little bit on my nose. For my blush, I'm using this Fenty cream blush. This is in the shade Summertime Wine. I'm just using a little itty bitty sponge because y'all know I don't like a whole lot of blush color. So I'm just gonna use the butt of this sponge to press it in. And actually, I think I'm just gonna put it on with the sponge and then blend it out with my fingers. And I know it looks super heavy, but we're going over it with foundation, so it's gonna tone it down. And I like to smile when I put on blush, just so that you know it's like really on the apples of your cheeks. Ooh. Look like we straight out of the 80s. So I'm just packing that in. I think that's it for everything that goes underneath. I did my contour, my highlight, blush. Yeah, I think that's everything. So now I'm just gonna go in with my foundation. I'm just using the one from Huda Beauty, the liquid foundation from Huda Beauty. And I'm just using one pump because the purpose of underpainting is that so that you don't have to use as much foundation. So I'm just gonna go over my cheeks, of course, and then of course the rest of my face that doesn't have any product on it. Right now I'm just setting underneath my eye with the Laura Mercier translucent honey powder. And I'm just pressing it in. I'm not gonna bake. I'm also gonna use this where I highlight it. So in the center of my forehead, my chin, and my nose. It's coming together, it looks good. Actually, I do see a difference now that I have like the setting powder and stuff. I like it. For the rest of my face, I'm just setting with my Fenty setting powder. This one is also in the shade Honey, I think. Yeah, Honey. Okay, so I do want to go in and add a little more highlight. So I'm just taking this one from Artist Couture. It's in the shade Illuminati. All right, so that's it for the face. So I'm just gonna do a real quick simple eye, nothing crazy. So for my eyes, I'm just using this palette from Natasha Denona. This one is called Peak. And I'm not gonna talk through this, I'm just gonna speed through it real quick. I think I'm gonna do it like a deep color today. I feel like I don't do that too much. I'm just going out with this Makeup Revolution pencil. This is more purple. I don't know why I thought it was more brown. Now I'm going in with Gumbo from the Crayon case. I I feel like my lashes are crooked, so it's making me look cockeyed. Okay, but this is the final look. I feel like I just wanted to touch up my powder a little bit because I think I look just a little shiny for my liking, especially like in this area. So I'm just gonna go in with that Fenty powder again and just press it in this area with a sponge. When I first put on my makeup, I do prefer like a more matte look because I know it's gonna get shiny within a few hours. And it's also gonna get a little bit shiny after I spray my setting spray. I wanted to really like this one for Morphe, even though Morphe is technically canceled. But this is my second one, and for some reason the nozzle just does not work. Like, I like the idea of like the continuous mist, but it just does not work. And I don't know like what the issue is. So I'm just gonna go back in with my Urban Decay the Slick spray. Spray that all over. And sometimes with the setting sprays, they do like end up looking a little patchy from where they don't spray evenly. So I just take a sponge and press it in. So I know I look totally different, and that's because it's like a week later and I went back to edit the footage for this video and I really didn't like the outro. And it was because at that time, I didn't realize like just how good my makeup looked. So I spent like the majority of the outro just saying like I didn't really see a difference. But then like as soon as I stopped filming and I looked at myself like outside of this setup, because I have three lights. I have like two here and then of course the ring light in the middle. And sometimes like all of these bright lights make it really hard to like really see what stuff like looks like. And you know, studio lights always looks way different from natural lighting. So it wasn't until after I had already finished recording that I realized that my makeup looked really good and I actually like the underpainting method. I actually did it again today. I did use different products though, but I really just wanted to make sure that I had an outro that really expressed how I truly felt about the underpainting technique. I actually really like it. I don't have to use as much foundation. It just looks a lot more smooth and natural because it's not as much foundation. So yeah, I couldn't use that footage that I had. So I had to make sure that I sat down and just made it clear that I do like underpainting. Yeah, so I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you want to see how I got this look that I'm wearing now, and I use all drugstore products, just stay tuned because that video will be coming soon. But yes, guys, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up if you learned something today. Are you going to use underpainting in the future? Do you think it's life-changing? Let me know in the comments down below. I hope that you guys are staying safe, and I will see y'all in the next one. Bye.